Hello Explorers and welcome to another video. Today we are going to talk about Cloud-Init and how you can use that in order to start your VMs. And this is something that is used a lot by Amazon, Microsoft, Azure, also Proxmox and so on, in order to start small images and get going. So what prompted this video was an email from Alex Grummer. Not sure if that surname is correctly pronounced. Sorry if not. Hi, may I ask why you went this way and not using Debian Cloud-Init images? This can be customized with a tool and Cloud-Init will create user and SSH key. They are very minimal. I got geek sniped pretty much because I went all the way down and tried to figure out how these works and learn more about them. And currently I think I have somewhat of a grasp, and I also have an answer to why I did not use them. So we're gonna come to that later in this video. But let's start with a small demonstration on how they work. So first off, we need to download one of these cloud images. So the cloud images could be found at cloud.debian.org, images cloud, and Trixie in my case, and there is generic cloud. If you search for Debian cloud images, you will find this as well. But let's download this one. It's very small. As you see, it's just 300 megabytes, so not much at all. I will rename this one to test, because just to have a little bit of a smaller name when we are working with them. And what I want to do now is add some extra to this image to make it more usable for me. So I will run something called NBD. So I mod prod NBD, and I say that I want maximum of partitions of 8. So give me a max of 8 partitions. And what we can do with these partitions is that we can connect this image to this kind of device. So I will connect it to the device 0, this test image. See if we disconnect one of these, if that works. Disconnected. Yeah, so it was connected already. So let's disconnect the second one as well. So now I have connected this image. And as you see, you can also disconnect them. When you have connected this image, you can mount one of the partitions there. And I figured out that partition 1 is the one that I want to be mounted. And on this image, I want to edit one file. And this file is in MNT, etc, cloud. So we have a cloud configuration there. And then cloud cfg d. So that there you can put more names or more files. And there is already a logging file there, but I will add a data source configuration, and this file will be like this. So we will have a data source, no cloud is this particular kind of cloud get thing where it will go out and fetch files, or it will use files in order to initialize this service. And in my case, I say that it seeds from, and then the IP address of node 5 in my case, because I have a service there. And then I wanted to use the system UUID. And then after that, it will fetch a file. So the final one would be something like network config. So that is the actual address it will go to. So when we have added this, it will go to my service and fetch the configurations. So now we have edited this image, and then we will unmount it. So let's do that again. And then we will disconnect the image. So we will run qmu-nbd disconnect, and that will disconnect the image. So now we have configured this image, we have edited this image, and now we can start it with our UUID. So I will run a very long command here. So I will use virt install, This is also in a package called virt install, so you can install that on Debian if you want. So this is using the libvirt system, and we will name this image Cloud-Init 001, and then we will use a memory of 4 gigabytes. We will do no reboot. The OS variant will be detect. It will detect it, and we say that it is a Debian 11. It is a Debian 13, but in my installation, Debian 13 is not yet specified, so I will take 11 just because I know that is available. We'll say that this will be a 10 gigabyte file, and it will use this file as a backing store, which means that it will take this image and then resizes to 10 gigabytes in order to have a new system. So it will resize it and add more to it. And then we say that we want to boot the HD with a menu. So you can set menu off here if you don't want to see the menu. We will import this image. And then we will say that we don't want an auto console, so we don't want it to open up in the window this particular image, and the reason I say that is because I may want to start up or create like 5 of these, and then I could run multiple after each other, and I don't want all of them to pop up windows. And then we say that I want to use my network bridge on this interface, so I set up a bridge interface, so it will get an IP on my local network. And then here comes a really interesting thing, metadata, UUID, and then we put a UUID, and this is already specified in my console. We will look at that later. So if we run this command, it will create a cloud image, and then we could start that cloud image using this command. After a lot of trial and error, I finally got it booted with the right name here, cloud test. And if we look under the network here, we see that it got 100 as its IP, which should be correct. So if we log in here, we should be able to get into 100. And currently it has problematic because I've been into it multiple times. So and the user, of course, is Debian. And it has added my cloud keys. So this was correctly configured. And if we switch over to my configuration here, you see that I have created a little interface where you could put in a UUID. When it comes to this configuration, we have a network configuration. And here we set the IP address that we were talking about, my gateway and some DNS service and so on. So that is a pretty interesting, simple way of configuring this. And then we have vendor data. I haven't added anything there. User data. Here we say that I want to use public keys. I want to disable the root login, disable root options. We will delete old SSH keys. We will use generate new keys of the ED25519 type. We will import my GitHub user ID key. And then we will set the host name to Clouder. Mm-hmm. That's interesting. And then we will have this cloudtestei.org as our FQDN. And we will create a hostname file, and we will prefer this over the hostname. So, and metadata, I've just put some instance ID. And all these files are pretty much propagated through this. So if we go to this node/metadata, we will get the metadata, for instance. So this is just a service that will give you the information back when you are calling for it. And I thought that this would be much easier for me to manage if I wanted to have multiple hosts that were configured through cloud images. If I wanted to install 10 hosts to run some experiment, I would just create a bunch of configurations here with multiple UUIDs and then just start them up and get them running. So that was my thought with this little implementation, and this is available on GitHub, of course, so it should be no problem to fetch and start working with it if you want to. I have a link in the description to this GitHub repository. But let's continue to look into what actually is going on here. So if we first off remove this here, so let's log out. I will go in here and close this one. And here we have this cloud init. We will force it off and we will delete it. So now I have removed that instance. And then I have this Debian 13. It's already running. And this is one of my normal installations and it's available on 143. So if we go back here and then SSH into 143. And add that fingerprint. So now I'm into this host. To set up this cloud init, we need to install a bunch of things. So first off, we need to have, I think it's easier if we just become root on this server because I haven't installed SSH yet or sudo. So therefore we become root. So what we will install is Google Guest agent, the VA agent, and the QMN guest agent, the cloud guest utils, and the cloud init. And these, I think this is one is for Azure, and then you have the guest cloud image and cloud init is for the normal, of course. Then you have Google guest agent, and I think there is another one if you want to run it in Amazon cloud. So there's a bunch of these kind of agents that are installed. And you see that there is a bunch of Python packages that are installed as well that is required to run this. So it's not a default Debian install with no extra packages we are creating here. We are creating a very particular cloud image with some extras. And I guess that the real cloud image contains even more packages to be supporting even more clouds. So it's a very specific setup we have there. And then when this is installed, we need to check that we have Virtue available in the kernel, and mostly for block devices and for network. Those are the important ones, and we see that those are modules here. So those are available. And then we will edit the data source file again and add my data source to that. We can also check in my particular installation on the network interfaces. We see that the default network interfaces interface is DHCP, and that is actually required for it to work here. So the cloud image is probably configured in a different way in order to handle this network connection. But if you don't have a DHCP, so it actually finds the network, how should it be able to go out and fetch a new configuration? And because I have DHCP here, it means that this host will get two IP addresses when it's actually set up. So I haven't really figured out how to get it set up correctly, exactly like a cloud image, but we can see that there is quite a difference between a regular install and a cloud image. And so now I will, we can probably log in here again and shut it down the right way. Shut down just so we don't have any issues in it. So now that it's shut down, I will delete it, but I won't delete the actual image. I will keep the image, delete the service. So now when I go back here, we can copy this image file into my current directory and I will call it Debian 13-2, just so I have a new name for it. And we move it into this directory, and then I can run this virt install again. Remove the first one there. So now we have virt install, the same name, Debian 11, another backing file, and the same UUID. So this should probably create a new image, same name here. And if we start that up with a bit, little bit of luck, this will start up very similarly into a Debian installation and give it the IP address of 100. I realized during editing that I had started the wrong image. So let's do this again with the right image. So here we can see that we now have Debian 13-2, which was the one that I was actually copying. So let's create that here and then go over here and start it up. So let's see how the startup process looks now. Probably should go a bit faster than previous. Should find the network pretty fast. But when it comes to this image, this cloud image setup, we can see that a normal Debian bare metal install is a lot different from a cloud install. A bare metal install has just the packages required in order to run the system and get up and start it with that particular setup. And you can choose which extra packages you want to have installed. When it comes to these cloud images, you install a bunch of extra packages that is required for the different cloud. So if you have a standard cloud image, it will have extra binaries for handling cloud, Google Cloud, and Amazon Cloud, and Azure Cloud, which is not something that you are running in your local bare metal install. So the comparison between these different things are not equal. And that's why I'm usually not using these kind of setups. But we can see here that it started, it went pretty fast. It has now this IP of 100. It might be that the SSH server isn't restarted directly. So let's see if we can connect to this one and or if it needs some more time. But perhaps it's enough time, the time I've been jabbering around on here. But it's that kind of difference between these kind of images. It might not really matter for your install, but my tutorials come from the standpoint of having a bare metal install on a server that you want to set up a particular service and run that just for your use case. So it's more of an sysadmin kind of approach where you want to set up your own home lab, or if you're working for a company and have a lot of bare metal servers, or if you want to set up a lot of different virtual hosts on your company backbone. But I don't really do that many tutorials about how to set up things in the different clouds, because that's not my expertise. We don't have anything cloud hosted at the moment. So now we see that it has started up with the configuration that I had earlier and with my keys and everything like that. So I can just log in to that IP that I had set for this particular setup. So this was what I wanted to cover today. I hope that you found this interesting. I hope that you learned something today. If you liked this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. If you have any comments or suggestions, leave those in the comment section down below. The description will also have affiliate links or donation links if you want to support the channel. And I really hope to see you in the next video.